Thanks, Kelly. Hopefully you got all that poop cleaned up. Hi, I'm Zargoy Warbod, and welcome to 6 Minutes. Tonight we'll be taking a look at the U.S. bobsled team and their chances at the Brooks Winter Olympics coming up this Saturday night. We have their coach, Flint, Michigan, with them. We're going to take a look at their strategies and some of their opponents. Here they are. So, Flint, thanks for coming.
Before this interview goes anywhere, all right? Before this goes anywhere, I'm gonna need like a 40-pound bucket of beef jerky to just like rest my feet in. All right, I'm not saying anything until I get jerky between my toes.
Sir, don't have those kind of resources. Can we please get to the interview? First question: when did your passion for bobsledding begin?
When did it begin? I mean, where it all began. The womb, you know. I mean, like, okay, picture this. We gotta go back a while. I'd say 1965. My parents are in Louisiana, and they meet. They go a little. They do the old in and out. And about 12 months later, I come firing out of there, all slippery, like a bobsled. And my daddy sees me and he goes, "All right, that is a champion, born and raised, right there." And I'd say that's where my passion really began.
Sounds like a very interesting childhood. I realize that in your later years, you had some problems with addiction.
Well, yeah, about that. I mean, it was everything, really. You name it. I was baby aspirin, baby clothing, babies, iguana skin, Cheez-Its, birth control, toilet paper, aluminum foil, my eyelashes, of course. It was a dark period. I didn't actually. And then actually get off the iguana squin we told about last year.
Is any of that even edible? I mean, maybe the baby aspirin, but... Okay, that's the point. So, Flint, when did you meet the team? Your American team, of course.
Oh. American team? What do you insinuate? Of course, I'm an American man. I'm an American man, that's all I know. America! USA! USA! You know? American team. Of course it's an American team. I'm American man.
So I understand your patriotism, but you coached the Chinese team last Olympics.
Alright. You know me, man. I mean, wherever the money is, that's where Flint is. Patriotism. Who cares about what country it is? Whoever's paying the most, I'll run it.
So, Flint. How's life at home?
Well, Zargoid, it's honestly, it's perfect. I mean, it is the perfect American family. I mean, I love them to death. I got a beautiful baby boy and a loving wife, and you know, it's a Southern frat house. You know, we go to church, we sing our hymns, and we'll have every night feels like a big Thanksgiving. We have the whole family over. We got the turkey, we got the gravy. It's every night. It gets a little repetitive, to be honest, but. But yeah, it's excellent. I love it.
Oh, I haven't seen Flynn in 15 years. About the time Dylan was born.
I haven't there.
Let's just stop there.
That sounds wonderful. It's really great to hear you've got some balance in your life. You really need it. So, what do you think your chances in the upcoming Olympics are with your team?
I mean, to be honest, 100%, these boys are born champions. I met with their fathers when they were a couple months old and told them that they had to do this. So they've been training their whole lives, and I really don't see anybody who could beat us. The only real competition I'd be worried about is honestly me getting in there and trying to win on my own. Which might happen, it's happened before, and I have won. I've got over 1,000 gold medals. But besides that, I really can't see anyone beating my team. I'm a champion. They're good, but I'm a champion.
Well, that can't be true, but interesting. We talked to some of your competition, and they think a bit differently. Let's take a look.
So, Eric, what do you think of the American bobsled team?
Well, you know, I think they're a bunch of hosers, yeah? You know, running around thinking they're the best team out there. You know, Team Canada's the best one out there. Everyone knows that.
Hey, Kevin, I'm glad we got you here. So, what are your thoughts on the American bobsled team?
Jue puta, vos sos americanos, no saben cómo jugar!
Those backstabbing sons of... I coached every single one of those boys on those cameras. Are they gonna stab me in the back like that? Do they know who I am? Do they know Flint, Michigan is coaching the USA team?
You coach them? Okay, I think we've had enough with this guy. Let's meet the team. So, guys, could you tell us your names and your position on the sled?
I'm Drake, and I'm a power bottom, so I really slam it in there on bottom, and I push us through.
My name is Igor. I'm right pile driver. I drive the right.
Left.
My name's Steven, and I'm the front cockpit rider. I call the shots for the team. I really drive this team's cockpit hard.
So I think a lot of people out there are wondering how close you guys are. What's the chemistry like out there?
Yes, we are all one big family. We love each other. Much love, brothers.
I mean, it's all a journey, right? And it all starts usually the night before each match. We all share a bed together, you know? It's not a big bed. It's a twin. But we all just hang out and share a bed.
I give his foot a little tickle like this and he put him right to sleep. Little boy.
It's a brotherhood. Love these guys, you know? We do everything together. We bobsled. We live together. That's what it's all about.
Just a bunch of dudes hanging out, you know? We can't go wrong, man.
We eat a lot of pasta.
Yeah.
We love pasta in our house.
Yeah.
And feet. Feet too. And sleep. Together.
And their coach, right?
Me? Oh, and coach.
That's about me in the end. Oh, yeah. That's what it's all about.
Can't forget coach. What a guy.
Yeah.
He is awesome.
Yeah, you guys are underselling a little bit. Come on. I bet your coach would be here without
me. He's more than coach. He's like
a dad.
He's like father.
Yeah. Like a god almost, you know? Like a deity, watching over you.
We worship him.
All powerful.
We kiss him after every match.
On an average day, what's your training routine? How do you guys stay in such great shape?
You know, it usually starts with a little bit of sledding. Put on our nice tight clothes. Definitely can see who hasn't been hitting the gym lately. Then we go after to our dance workout.
I love the dancing. You go into a tight room and turn the heat up high. We just dance out every little pain we had that day. It's great stress relief.
Really gets us going, you know, just a bunch of guys dancing in a hot room.
Nothing better.
It's a good time.
Especially with my brothers. We all dance the same.
Yeah. You two have been awfully quiet. We want to hear a little more from you. What's your thoughts on the team?
Well, I'd definitely say we're the two most intellectual members of the group. Those other two guys, that Russian dud, he's a brick. What's his name, Blake, the other guy? Knows nothing, I mean, he's got a lot of power, I'll be honest, you know, he's back there in the sled, but he knows nothing. We're the real team. This is the real bobsledding team here.
Would you say there's some tension on the team? Is that fair to say?
Yeah, there's tension all over. You know, there's tension between the right pile driver and the cockpit driver. You know, left has some tension with his boys. You know, it gets tough sometimes.
Do you think it could jeopardize your experience at the Olympics?
No, we're the best. We're the best.
Igor, you have a police record. Is that anything to you when you come to America?
Rules are... I've always known rules of America. They're very strict. I'm a party boy sometimes, you know, but...
You party boy?
They get best of me, but...
Can you expand on your party boy side a little bit?
I go out and, you know, I told you about dancing. We dance and we go to clubs. It's hard not to do stuff.
Oh, I see.
A party.
Okay. Thanks, Igor.
Thank you.
So, Drake, now that we got you alone, you're known as the all-star of the team. Do you agree with that?
Yes, I would definitely agree with that. I couldn't put it better myself. I'm definitely better than the other guys. You know that cockpit rider, Steven, That's even his real name. He brings our team down. I mean, other teams might be able to catch up just because he can't ride cockpit.
Wow, those are pretty strong accusations.
Yeah, I'm not really into him. He's like, he can't dance, he can't ride cockpit. It's just, he's awful.
Okay.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting an end to my running and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you a-crying, you're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long.
So damn much. Almost as much as I love me.
Wow. What a disturbing segment. Good luck to everyone competing this Saturday night, and that's it.